Before we get started looking at his crosses, we need to address a couple things. So he studied characters or characteristics. We'll call them characters in the pea plant. Seven different characters. We will talk about three. These include seed color, plant height, and seed shape. And within these characters, he studied the clear and contrasting traits. So for seed color, we have yellow and green. For plant height, we have tall and dwarf. And for seed shape, we have round and wrinkled. Now he did four more traits. And importantly, for each of these traits, all of them were passed from parents to the offspring in a similar manner. So, before we go on, let me address Mendel's four postulates. So sometimes these are called laws. I think most genetic textbooks are moving away from describing these as laws. Instead, we're describing them as postulates. So Mendel's four postulates on inheritance or heredity. So he came up with these four postulates to describe the observations he made in doing his crosses. And these four postulates are alleles occur in pairs. So alleles for a character occur in pairs, except in gametes, right? And we're talking about P here. P is diploid, right? So that makes sense that the alleles would occur in pairs in most cells, except the gametes. So he came up with a postulate on dominance. So what dominance, the postulate on dominance says, when there are two unlike alleles in an individual, in this case, an individual pea plant, one is dominant over the other and one is recessive. The third postulate is on segregation. And what this says is that the paired alleles separate from each other during sexual reproduction. So gametes inherit one or the other with equal likelihood. So how about this? When paired alleles segregate or separate, gametes inherit one or the other with equal likelihood. And then finally, a postulate on independent assortment. And what this postulate says is that alleles for different characters, this would be like alleles for seed color versus alleles for seed shape. Alleles for different characters are sort independently of each other during gamete formation. Now, we're almost ready to take a look at Mendel's monohybrid cross, but let's introduce some modern terminology so we can understand.